Good evening, all participants. I hope I am audible. If I am audible, please respond on the chat. Please respond on the chat if I'm audible. Okay, fine. So my name is Umang Kejriwal, and I welcome you all to the live online training on data science using Python conducted by Finland Labs Gurgaon. And I am working as a corporate trainer in that company. So I welcome you all to this training. So I hope you all are excited for this training. So in this training, we will be discussing about data science. What is data science? What is the applications of data science? Okay. And what are the data life cycle? What are the different programming languages that we use in data science? And we will do some kinds of hands-on also on Pandas or NumPy, how to actually apply data science. We will do some kind of hands-on also. Okay. This all, overall, the scenario of the training is there. Okay, so I hope you all will enjoy that. And in case if you have any doubt or something, you can ask me at the last 10 minutes. Okay, so you can write your doubts in the notebook and you can ask me at the last 10 minutes. Okay, because in between, maybe I will not be able to see the chat. So it's better you can ask me at the last. Okay, and secondly, at the last, I will be sharing the attendance link with you all. So you have to fill that attendance form, and that is very mandatory for the certificate. Okay, so we'll wait for 3-4 minutes for other participants to join, and then we'll start in 3-4 minutes. So at 4 o'clock sharp we'll start. Yes, good evening Lavanya, good evening. Okay, you are also here. Yeah. Yeah, good evening, Ankit. Good evening. Good evening, Murali. Good evening, Raja, Avilas, Lokesh, all of you, good evening. And I hope all of you are fine. And I request you all, if you like, at the last, if you like the session, please subscribe and like the video and subscribe the channel. And you will be getting more trainings on this channel, okay, in future. Tanjot, like at the last, you will be getting one Google form that you have to fill for the attendance and for the certificate. So if you don't fill it, that you will not be getting the certificate. So that is required. So I'll share the link after the class, okay? So you can fill that form. Yes, yes. Good evening. Good evening. Hi, Mamta. Good evening. Good afternoon. Meanwhile, you can like introduce yourself from where you are. You can write your CT name. You can write your CT name from where you are watching this session. What you are doing right now. Are you a student? Are you a faculty? Are you a working professional? What you are, you can tell me. Let me see how many people are there. How many, what you are doing right now. Are you studying? Are you doing a job? What's the main motto of coming to this data science workshop? Do you want to learn about data science? What do you want to, why you are here? Okay, Gujarat, Hyderabad. Okay, okay. Engineering, I'm saying from Hyderabad, BTech third year. Okay, okay. Scientist in IMD. Okay, that's nice. I'm Khalil. I'm web developer. Okay, Delhi. MBA student. Oh, MBA student is also here. Very nice. Student from Bangalore. Bangalore. Swichita from ISD scholar from IIT Kharagpur. Okay, nice. Ankit from Delhi. Okay, I welcome you all again. I welcome you all. And I hope you all enjoy the session. This 2-hour session will be fruitful for you. Okay. and you will surely enjoy this. You want to become a data scientist? That's great, Raksha. That's great. I am from basically my name is Umang Kejriwal, and basically I live in Noida, but my hometown is in Patna. I belong from Patna, Bihar. Okay. Oh, you are from Bangladesh. Oh, we have a participant from Bangladesh also. Nice. Okay, Hyderabad. Okay, robotics. Okay, fine. Nice. Okay, that's great. Okay, so now just in 2 minutes we'll start. So first of all, we will cover something about data science. We'll know about something about data science. Ananya Ganguly from Kolkata. Okay, Varanasi. Okay. Basically, I have done BTech and MTech from electronics and communication. That's my qualification. And I have an experience of near about 7 years in the field of data science, machine learning, IoT, and web development and Android app development. From last 7 years, I am delivering the training on these technologies. Okay, so now let's start. We will discuss this later on. Now we will have the introduction later on, and if you have any doubt, you can write it down and you can ask me at the last. Okay, so let's start the training now. Okay, so let me share my slide. Just a minute. Yes, so I hope you all can see my slide. So data science. Now, what is data science? We will discuss in this first of all. Data science. Data science is also known as data-driven science that makes use of different scientific methods, processes, algorithms, and systems to extract the knowledge or insights with its goal to discover the hidden patterns from the raw data. Now, what do you mean by this? See, first of all, let us know about data. Like, see, we have a raw data. Now, do you know what is raw data? Raw data is what? The data that is in the original form. Maybe you have collected the data from survey. Maybe you have collected the data from some form. Maybe you have collected the data from some website. So that the data that you just collected is simply called the raw data. So it can have some error. It can have. It's not compulsory that it will be having the error. Maybe there will be some kind of error in the data. Error means some data will be missing. Some values will be missing. Okay. So that is basically called raw data. And data can be in any format. You can have the data in text format. You can have the data in image format. You can have it in audio. You can have it in video. Like in the text, we have different types. We have CSV format. CSV stands for comma separated value. Here the data is separated by comma. Then we have a TSV, tab separated value. Then we have a PDF. PDF you must have heard. Then we have an Excel. So lots of data form we are having. And the most common data set that we use is the CSV format. Then we have a image data, JPG, PNG, GIF. We have lots of image data. Audio, we have MP3. We have WAV, WAV. Lots of format of audio we are having. MP4, we have a MPG, MP4 video. So this is the types of data that we can use. It can be any kind of data. So after having that raw data, what we do, we apply some different scientific method, mathematical methods, processes, and different types of algorithm. And after applying that algorithm, we extract some knowledge or insights with its goal to discover the hidden patterns. That means from that data, we actually explore some new information. We find out some information from the data. So that is the data science. That is actually called data science. Okay. In other words, it is about finding and exploring the data in the real world and then using that knowledge to solve the business problem. So I'll come to that part just after this slide. How do we solve actually a business problem? I'll just come to that. Okay. Data science is applied by a data scientist whose primary role is to design and create processes for the complex as well as large scale data set. The person who apply the data science, they are known as data scientists. And right now in the IT industry, it's a highly paid job. It is one of the highly paid jobs in the IT industry. Highly paid job. The average salary for the data scientist is minimum 7 to 8 lakhs per annum. Minimum. I'm telling you that's a minimum salary. If you are having some knowledge of data science, you can take a salary of minimum 7 to 8 lakhs per annum. If you simply Google it, you will get to know. See, I will just show you. If I simply Google here, average salary of data scientist, and go to any website like Glassdoor is very, very famous website. Glassdoor, you must have heard about Glassdoor website. Let us check here. See here. 950k per year. You can see that's the average base pay. It is updated on 7th of August 2020. That's the average salary for the data scientist. And I told you 7 to 8 lakhs. So 950k means 950,000 per year. So if you are learning data science, if you are spending, if you have interest in data science, and if you are doing better in data science, you can have a huge, like in 1 or 2 years, your salary will be very much good. So we have huge amount of jobs also. After some time, I'll show you how many jobs are available for data science. There are lots of jobs available for the data science. Okay. So they are the data scientists whose primary role is to design and create processes for the complex as well as large scale data set. So data scientists basically design and create the processes for the complex as well as large scale data set. Now, what are the processes is involved? He is involved in processing, cleaning, verifying all the integrity of the data for the analysis. Like he verify all the integrity that which input or which part of the data is required for our purpose. He process the data. He clean the data. Clean the data means removes all the error from the data. So these are the processes in which he is involved. And he also build predictive models using machine learning algorithm. So he also apply machine learning algorithm also. So this is the basic introduction about the data science. And I hope you all are clear. Now you must have some idea about data science, what is actually the data science is. Okay. Now let us discuss some examples. First example is the customer prediction. System can be trained based on the customer behavior pattern to predict the likelihood of customer buying a product. It means we can train the system and we can predict what customer can buy in future from the website. Now, let me give you a simple example. Suppose I want to purchase a mobile. Suppose my range is between 30 to 40K. What I'm doing, I'm just going to the Flipkart website or Amazon website. Okay. And on that website, I'm just filtering some mobile. I'm just checking between this range. And now suppose I found one mobile that's very interesting and that is having a very good features, but the price is near about 42K.
Just suppose. Now, what I am just thinking, I have to take this mobile only. I have to purchase this mobile only. So what I am just decided that I will wait for some days. I will wait for some time. I think that maybe the price will go low after some week or after some days. So I will wait for some month or some days. Now, every 2 or 3 days, I'm just visiting the Amazon website and I'm checking the price every day. That this the price goes down or not. I'm just checking the price every day. Now I want to ask you all the participants, just reply in the chat. If you are the owner of the website, and if you are just seeing that I am visiting your website daily and I'm checking the same mobile every day, so what do you will think? What do you think about me? What is the first thing in the mind that you will get? If I am visiting your website daily and I'm checking a new mobile, say same mobile every day. Yes, you will think that I am planning to buy. I want to purchase that. And you may think that why I'm not purchasing? Maybe the price is higher. That's why I'm not purchasing. Or maybe I am confused. So in that case, what you will do? If you have some margin, suppose if you are having some margin, what you will do, you will make some coupon. You will make some coupon and you can email me. You can email me that there is some offer you can right now buy. So if that price is up, if that price is according to my budget, then I will definitely buy that mobile. So that's an example of data science. In all the websites right now, whenever you visit any website, you must have seen one notification of cookies. They say you that we are collecting your data for advertisement. We are using your details for advertisement. So whenever you visit any website, there are some cookies and there are some scripts running on the background, which actually monitors on which page you are spending the time, on which page you are visiting so much. These all things are monitored and stored in a database. So using that data, the website owner simply knows, because there is a system trained which tells according to that data that what customer actually want to buy. And if there will be some offer, he will definitely send you, they will definitely send you email, or you may get the advertisement of that mobile. This is an example of data science. This is all done by the data science only. Okay, so I hope this thing is clear to all. Now, second thing is service planning. Restaurants can predict how many customers will visit on a weekend and plan their food inventory to handle the demand. Now, let me give an example. Like suppose 31st January is there, 31st December is there, and we have a weekend, like we have a New Year party. Suppose I have a restaurant and I have a New Year party, and I want to decide, I want to know how many customers will be coming to my restaurant for eating the food on that 31st December or 1st January. What we will do in this ad case, I will look to my all previous year data and we will see that how many customers visit on my restaurant every year. According to that data, we can analyze that in this year, how many customer will be coming. But maybe, see, there may be some, it's not compulsory that it will be correct. Maybe after that previous year, your quality has been reduced. Your restaurant's quality has been reduced. So maybe the customer will reduce also. And maybe you have improved your quality, so maybe the footprint can be increased also. So, but somehow we can predict the number of customers coming on the 31st December or January or 1st January. So we can plan our food inventory accordingly. Like just 2 days back, we have a sale on Amazon, right? On 6th on 7th August, we have a sale on Amazon. So what Amazon can plan, he can look to the previous sale data and he can simply analyze that how many customers were visiting on their website. So he can plan their server details, server load, so that whenever any customer will be coming on that website, the site do not go low. The site do not get down. The site should be running. That is the example of service planning. Okay. So this is the example of data science. So I hope you all are, I hope now it's clear about data science, what exactly we do with the data science. I hope it's clear, all of you. What exactly we do with the data science. Okay. Now, what are the different programming languages that we use for data science? The first one is the R programming. Second one, you must have heard about this, a very famous one, that is Python. Third one is the SQL. Fourth is the MATLAB. Fifth is the Java. And sixth is the SAS. We have other programming languages also. I cannot take all the programming languages here, but these are the common programming languages that you can use it for data science. Out of these, the most famous one and the most used one is the, which one? Python. Python or R, which most of the company use. Python or R. Python was launched in 1990. But we were not knowing about the Python that time. But right now, after the coming of data science, machine learning, AI, this Python language has become very famous. It has become very famous now, because it has inbuilt so many libraries that helps developer or scientist, data scientist, to write the code in a simple way, in a very short form. It makes the work easier. That's the use of Python. That's a magic of Python. So it depends on you what you want to use. Either you can use SQL, either you can use Python, you can use R, Java, MATLAB, SAS. Whatever you want to use, you can use according to your need. That totally depends on you. So now let me compare why actually we use Python mostly. What are the different, what is the features of Python? What are the features of Python? First thing is simple and easy to learn. It's very simple and easy to learn. Like right now, class 7-8 students are also doing the coding on Python. 7-8 students are doing the coding on Python. Like I have taken one batch, like 15 or 20 days back. In that batch, lots of like participants were from from engineering background. Some of you are doing engineering, some of your faculty, some of them are industrial person. But there was one boy who was just in class 8, and he was learning it very better. He was very smart, actually. So Python is this much simple, like even class 7 student can also learn Python. It's very simple to understand. It's very simple. So he was performing very well in that training. So it's very simple to understand. Fit for many platforms. It's not platform dependent. We can use it on Windows. We can use it on Mac that is of Apple. We can use it on Linux. So that's very, it's not platform dependent. You can use it on any platform. High level and interpreted language. It's a high level language and it has its own interpreter. I hope you all know interpreter. Interpreter is what? That converts from one form to another form. So it has its own interpreter. So we do not have to use separate interpreter for Python like we use in C language. Perform data manipulation, analysis, and visualization. It's very simple to perform data manipulation, analysis, and visualization. There's lots of libraries available for this. Like we have a Pandas, we have NumPy, we have SciPy, We have Matplotlib for visualization. We have Plotly. We have Seaborn. We have lots of libraries which help us to make it more easier. Then it works as a scripting language also. Acts as a scripting means that we actually execute, in the background. That you mean by a scripting, that we execute in the background. That is actually called scripting language. Okay. And the last one is powerful libraries for machine learning application and other scientific computation that I already told. We have lots of libraries that makes very easier for applying machine learning for data manipulation, scientific computation and all. Okay. So now, this was the features of Python. That's why we use Python for the data science. Now, what is the data life cycle? As a data scientist, how do you proceed? How do you proceed to apply the data science? So the first step is the discovery of data. Discovery simply means collection of data. Collection of data. And the data will be what? It will be raw data. The data will be raw data. Okay. So basically the collection of data is called a discovery of data. After collecting the raw data, we do the data preparation. Now, what is data preparation? In the data preparation, we also know call this data preparation as a pre-processing of data. Pre-processing of data. Now, what do you mean by this pre-processing of data? See, there are some steps that we can do in pre-processing. The first step, if I go from sequence, first of all, what we do, we import the data. It can be from CSV file, can be from any kind of file. Then we can convert the data type of the data, convert the data type according to our need. Suppose we have a date data, so we convert into date time format. Convert the data type if we need. If we have a number numeric data, we can convert into integer or float or any kind of data. Then what we can do? We can add or delete the columns if we have a data in the form of rows and columns. So we can add or delete the rows and columns. Next thing, we can filter the data according to our need. Just a minute. According to our need means, suppose there are total 10 columns in the data, and I want, in for my purpose, I need only 5 data. So I can filter out 5 data. That is called filtering of data. Next one we can have is working with the null values. Working with null values means either removing the null values or replacing the null value. Removing or replacing the null values. Okay. So null values means missing values. Null is something called missing values. Next one we have label encoding. Now, what is label encoding? Label encoding means converting the string data into numeric form. Like suppose we have a categorical data. Categorical data, let's suppose gender. So in the gender, we have male and female. For applying the data scientific operation or mathematical operation, we cannot apply on the string data. So we have to convert into numeric. So we can convert male to 0 and female to 1. So this is called label encoding. Then we have scaling or normalization of data. Scaling or normalization of data. Scaling or normalization means, suppose we have the data between the range 0 to 100. The values of the data will be between 0 to 100. So this 0 to 100 will be converted to 0 to 1 or minus 1 to 1. So that's the meaning of scaling or normalization of data. If I explain you with a diagram, what is scaling means? Scaling means, like suppose, we have the data like this. So after scaling, the data will become like this. That means we are reducing the scatteredness from the data. We are reducing the scatteredness from the data. And that actually increases the accuracy of the model. Okay. Yes, making it compact to study. That's correct. So this is about the data preparation. Now, after data preparation, your machine learning actually starts from here. So from here, your machine learning starts. The first step is the model planning. Model planning means planning the model. Model means algorithm. Planning the algorithm according to our data. Suppose I want to predict something, so which algorithm will help me to predict that data? That is called model planning. That means, suppose if I give you a simple mathematical problem, what you do? First of all, decide which theorem, which formula will be applicable to this problem statement. And then you apply the formula. So that is called model planning. Deciding the algorithm. After deciding the algorithm, we build the model. That means we create the model. After creating, we perform the training. That means we apply the data to the training. And after applying, we do some kind of prediction. If the result is not up to the mark, if it is having not good accuracy, then that this all steps will be repeated. These all steps will be repeated. Maybe you have not collected the data enough. It's not enough. Maybe you have not prepared the data well. Maybe you have not chosen the correct model. So you have to apply all the process again. So one-stop solution for all these operations. That is data scientist. All operations are done by the data scientist only. Okay, so this was about the data life cycle. Now, data manipulation. It helps us to extract, filter, and transform our data quickly and efficiently. That is called data manipulation. So for data manipulation, we use NumPy and Pandas. These are general libraries that we use it for data manipulation. There are other libraries also, But here I am just considering only one thing, named NumPy and pandas. So let us discuss in short about NumPy and pandas. Okay, by mistake, I've given the logo of pandas here. So I'll change it, no problem. Don't confuse with this. This is the logo of pandas actually. Okay. NumPy is what? A Python package that stands for numerical Python. It is used for scientific computing, which contains an array object. We can use it for scientific computing, mathematical operation, any kind of mathematical operation. You can use it for NumPy for any kind of mathematical operation. You can use NumPy. And basically, it contains an array object to create a matrix, to generate some random number, to generate a number between some range, to create a zero matrix, identity matrix, null matrix. For all this purpose, we can use the NumPy to calculate average, to calculate standard deviation, these all things. Installation, this is for the installation command, and this is for the import. So that's not important right now. Pandas, a Python package which is used for data manipulation and analysis. So with the help of pandas, you can actually manipulate the data. You can, whatever the things I discussed in the data life cycle, in the data pre-processing steps, filtering data, sorting data, searching the data, deleting and adding the rows to the data, these all things can be done by the pandas. All the things can be done by the pandas. So also used for data like matrix data, tabular data, statistical data, and all many kind of heterogeneous data also. Okay. So this was all about the pandas. So that's all for the data science part that I have to discuss. So now we will do some kind of hands-on on this. Then you will be getting some idea how actually we work on pandas or NumPy or data science. Okay. No, Madhav, there is no code for today. So see, for hands-on, we will be using one platform that is Google Colab. Google Colab is actually, let me show you the Google Colab. Google Colab is actually a notebook kind of a IDE. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, which you can use for writing the code for Python. It is created by the Google company. It's an online editor where you will get all the libraries pre-installed. So you can use this Google Colab for writing the code, any code for Python. You can use it in, you can open this Google Colab in the mobile also. So here I will be writing some code. Here I will be writing some code related to the data science. I was explaining some code. I will be taking one data set. In that data set, I will actually tell you how to apply data science. So let me open the Google Colab first. I'll simply open this. And if you are not logged into your Google account, it will ask you to log into the Google account. And after login, you will be getting the page like this, or you can get a page like this. You can go to file and you can take a new notebook file. You can take a new notebook file. Yes, I will share the link for that if you want. Okay. Yeah, so this is my Google Colab. This is how it looks like. If you have worked on a Jupyter notebook, you must be knowing about this. It's similar to that Jupyter notebook. Okay. No, it will be stored in the Google Drive. The code will be stored in your Google Drive by default. Okay. So here, this is the file name. I can change the file name here. So I'm giving the file name as data preprocessing of Titanic data set. Titanic data set. That's a link. Okay. So Titanic data set. Now let me show you the Titanic data set. You can download it, or let me, I will share with you that data set. I will share with my GitHub file. So, machine learning. So you can see this is the Titanic data set, and it is a high-purpose CSV file. If I originally show you this data, let me show you this data. Wait. This is the Titanic data set, you can see. I have opened this in the MS Excel. That's why it is looking like a form, looking like a table. But actually, this is a CSV file. If I open this with the notepad, see, I'll show you. See, all the columns are separated by comma. All the columns are separated by comma. You can see here. So that's a CSV file. Okay. So what I will do here, I will share this file with you. You can download this file, or you can directly use the link to read the file in the notebook. So I'm going to share this link on the chat. Either you can use this link, or you can right click and save this file. You can save as this file, Control S, and save as this file in your system. Okay. So I'll directly use a link in my notebook. So here I will write link is equal to, I'll write here this. And for executing, you have to press Shift plus Enter. For executing any code, you have to press Shift plus Enter to execute. Shift plus Enter to execute. Now the code has been executed. Now I have to read this file. So for this, I will be using pandas. Import pandas as pd. Data is equal to pd dot read underscore csv. Read csv is the function that is used to read the data. Link. This is the data that I have imported here. This is the data that I have imported here. Now, if I look to this data, there are lots of NaN values. NaN means not a number. That means this is a null value. This is actually a null value. Okay. So this null values we have to remove. So for looking the proper information about the data, you can write here, see total we have 891 rows. I can write here data.info. See, this is the information about my data. Okay, I'll save this file. This is my file link where you can see my coding. Okay. Now you can see here it is showing me that total there are 12 columns. The entries are 891 entries. In the passenger ID column, we have total 891 non-null entries. That means there is no null values here. 714 non-null values. That means near about 100 and something values are null here. Values are null here. Then here we have near about 700 values are null. Near about 700 values are null here. So we have lots of null values. So we will remove this. Now, what is this data actually? This data is of the Titanic ship, the list of the passengers who were traveling in the Titanic. So here passenger ID means that's the ID of the passenger. Survived zero means that this passenger has died. And here one means he or she has not died. He was alive. Then this one is the passenger class. He was traveling in which class? First class, second class, or third class? Then we have the name of the passenger. Then we have the sex, either male or female. Then we have the age, number of siblings and spouse. How many number of siblings and spouse traveling with him? Parch is the number of relatives who were living abroad. That is the meaning of parch. Then we have a ticket number. Then we have a fare, how much he has paid. Then the cabin number. Here NAN means it's a blank value. And then we have a embarked. Embarked means from where he boarded the Titanic. So there were three places: Southampton, Cherbourg, and Queenstown. There were three places from where they have boarded. And if you want to know the information of this data set, you can simply Google Titanic data set. And see, on the Kaggle website, if you go here, if you scroll down, data. See here, all the informations are mentioned here. You can see. Okay. Now, so first of all, I told you whenever we have to apply some kind of data science or something, we never apply to the string data. We never apply to the string data. First of all, suppose I want to remove all the columns that are having the string data. Now, just tell me all of you. I'll ask one by one. Suppose I want to use this data. For predicting whether the passenger has died or not. I want to predict the life of passenger, whether he or she has died or not. So, do passenger ID have any relation with the survival? Sorry. One by one, you can tell me. Passenger ID. No. All of you are saying no. Do passenger class will affect the survival column? Passenger class. I'm just asking, what are the inputs, what are the columns that will affect the survival column? So do passenger class will affect the survival? With your answer, yes or no, please write the column name also, because I don't know whether you are writing no for this or no for this. Okay. So passenger class may affect, like maybe the first class passenger have given more security. So maybe the passenger class will affect the survival column. Then name will not matter at all. Name doesn't matter at all. Then sex. It will matter. Maybe the female have given more priority. Maybe the female have given more security. Age will also matter. Maybe the children, maybe the oldest people, they have given more security. The number of siblings and spouse, number of parch, that we can say may or may not. That's not compulsory. May or may not. Ticket number, nothing. Not at all. Not at all. Fare, we can consider fare. Maybe those who have paid more, that means they are from first class or second class. So maybe that will matter. Cabin doesn't matter at all. And embark may matter or may not matter. Maybe may or may not it matters. So I will simply remove all the columns which doesn't matter at all. It doesn't matter at all. So for removing the columns, I will write here. Acha, if I write here data.head, it will print only the first five rows. Only the first five rows. Now I want to delete some columns. So I will write here data equal to data dot drop. In the list, I will pass the column's name. So I want to delete passenger ID. So this should match with this. It is case sensitive. Then we will delete name. Then we will delete ticket number. Let's delete ticket number. And cabin. Yeah, that's it. These four columns we will delete. And after this, I'll write here axis equal to 1. So here axis equal to 1 means I am deleting the columns. If I write here axis equal to 0, it will consider that as a row. Now if I execute this and if I write here data dot head, see, my all data is now removed. Okay. Now what I want to do, I want to basically convert the string data into numeric data. String data. Before coming to that part, let us check how many null values are there in the data. Let us check how many null values are there in the data. So we will write here data dot is null. Dot sum. Here you can see I am getting total 177 null values in the age column and two null values in the embarked column. Now just tell me what will be the better option here, to remove the null value or to replace the null value? Which one will be more better option, either to remove or to replace? Yes, all of you are saying replace. Why we cannot remove? Because if I will remove, 177 data will be reduced. So my total data is 891. So if I'll remove the null values, out of 891 rows, 177 number of rows will be deleted. So my data will become less. So why to remove the data? So we'll replace the age value. We'll replace all the null values of age with some value. Now tell me, from what value should I replace? What values should we replace? NaN value will be replaced by what value? Yes, average value, correct. Average value will be better option. See, we cannot perform mathematical operation on null data. How can you apply a mathematical operation on null data? Null data means nothing. There is nothing. Arav, let me clear you this, whatever you are asking. You are saying, see, Arav actually asked a good question. Many of the participants may have the confusion like this. See, what Arav is saying, suppose we have, suppose, okay, suppose this is the data that we are having right now. Now here we have null value and here we have null value. Now Arav, you only just tell me, Arav, can we remove this part only? Is it possible to remove only this part? Is it possible to remove only these two part? If you are removing this two part, that means this is also on null only, na? This is also null only. We have to remove the entire row. Yes. I hope now the confusion is clear. Okay. So now I hope you are clear now. Okay. Removing doesn't mean replacing. Replacing is different. Removing is different. Okay. So let's come back here. So what we will do, we will replace all the null values of the age column with the average value of the age. Average value of the age. So how to calculate the average value of age? Now let me tell you. So data of age. If I write like this, data of age, that means I am just printing the age column. See, it will simply give the age data. If I write here data of age dot mean, it will give you the mean value of the age column. Mean of age equal to this. If I print this, it's giving me 29.6991176 something. That's the mean value of age. Now what I will do, I will round this value up to 2 decimal. So for this, I will use the NumPy library. I will write here np.round mean age. See, it has rounded to an integer kind of a thing, like totally it has rounded. Now if I want to round up to 2 decimal, I will pass here comma 2. So it will round up to 2 decimal. See. Okay. Round up to 2 decimal, 29.70. Now I want to replace all the null value of the age with the null value of the age with the mean value of the age. I want to replace that. So what I will do in that case, I will write here data of age. That means I am replacing the age column with data of age dot fill an A. Fill an A means fill the null values. And I will fill the null values with mean of age. Mean of age. And now if I check, see, now we don't have any null value in the age. Now it has zero. Now for the embark, now tell me what will be the better option for embark, remove or replace? Remove or replace? Remove, yes, because two rows will not affect anything. So two rows cannot affect anything. I'll write here data is equal to data dot drop NA. Drop NA means drop all the null rows from the data. Drop all the null rows from the data. And if I print data now, okay, let me execute this. Now, if I see this, see, now the data is completely cleaned. Now we don't have any kind of missing values. No, replace is not accurate every time, Arav. Yes, that depends on the data. It's not like replace will work every time better way. No, it may change the accuracy. Accuracy may be affected. Here we do not give access. Here we do not give the access. That's all. Ritik, see, that in place is what I do in place if I don't write like this. See, in place is used when I don't write like this. Here you use in place like this. In place actually do the same thing that we have done here. Okay. Now, so that's my data now. Now, what I want to do, now I want to replace the string data into a numeric data. So here we have two columns. Here we have two columns where we have a string data. The first one is the sex and the second one is the embark. So how to do that? So let us see how many unique values are there. Data of sex dot unique. In the sex column, we will have only two unique data, male and female. No, we do not delete the embark. We have not deleted the embark. And in the embarked, we are having three unique values, S, C, and Q. Yes, tail is used for bottom five rows. Yes. Now, I want to replace with male with 0 and female with 1. Male with 0 and female with 1. So, I will write data of sex is equal to data of sex dot map. Map function we will use here. And here we will create a dictionary. In the dictionary, I will pass male will be replaced to 0 and female will be replaced to 1. Then, now if I see data dot head, yes, that's a label encoding. Yes, this is a label encoding. Same thing we will do it for embarked. So we have S. S will be replaced to 0. C will be replaced to 1. And Q will be replaced to 2. No, tail is not for columns. Tail is for bottom five data. Tail is for bottom five rows. See, bottom five rows. That's for tail. Okay. So now we have actually cleaned my data. Now suppose you want to filter the data, you want to sort the data by, tell me what should I sort? You just tell me from which column should I sort the data. Tell me from which column. Pratyush, we do not do label encoding for multiple data. We just do the label encoding for categorical data where we have two categories, three categories or four categories. Like in the case of cities, we cannot do that. We have to remove that column. Okay, let's do it for age. So I'll write here, sorting the data by age, plotting the data by age. I'll write here data is equal to data dot sort underscore values, sort underscore values, and pass here I want to sort it by age. And in which ascending, I write here ascending is equal to true. That means it will be doing in the ascending order. A is capital. B, ascending order. Oh my God. 0.42 is the age. See, there were the passengers who were from 4 months. 4 months also. Yes, level encoding is necessary. Yes. If I write here false, no, there is no need for sorting. I'm telling you how can you sort. No need for sorting. I'm telling you how can you sort if you want to sort. See. Okay. So that's how we apply data science. See, if we apply the data science here, and actually we have created our data set with a cleaned data set. Now here you can see the index, the ID column has been now disturbed. When I sort the data, it is disturbed now. So if you want to reset it, you can reset also. You can write here, data is equal to data dot reset underscore index. The data will be resetted. Now the index will start from zero. Now the previous index is now added as a column. The previous index is now added as a column. I can remove this column, and you all know how to remove. Data dot drop. Index. X is equal to 1. So this was all about the basic thing about data science. We have lots of things that we can do in data science. We have lots of things. Like, it's a very big field. We can do lots of things. We can visualize the data in graph. That is a part of data visualization, data analysis. So we can do lots of things. So I hope you all get the overview of the data science. No, if you sort the index, Arav, if you sort the index, I have sorted the data by age. So again, your data will become unsorted. If you sort the data by index, I don't want to change the age column. Na? That's why I have reset the index. Okay. Now see, now let me show you jobs. Like if you simply search on Google, jobs in data science. If you want to display 20 lines, it's the 20 lines. See, okay. So you can see now. Let me go to any Naukri.com. You can see how many openings are there in data science. AT&T, that's a very good company. AT&T. You can see lots of openings are there. data scientist, data scientist, data scientist. Can see. See here, senior manager, data scientist. The manager salary is 11 lakh to 12 lakh per annum. Data scientist, you can see how many jobs are right now there. So if you learn data scientist and if you are unemployed right now, definitely if you are learning it in a better way, you'll definitely get a job. Definitely. Because all the companies are working on data, because we right now, you all know, data is very important right now. We have lots of news in the, like, why the apps has been banned. Why the apps has been banned? You must be knowing that there are lots of China apps that has been banned. Why they are banned? Just because of data only. They were stealing our data. They were stealing our data. So our data is very important. All the companies use the data to do anything. You can be like data, all the companies are using the data. So if they are using the data, they need a data scientist. Okay. This was all about the data science. I hope you all understand what is actually the data science is. Yeah. So now if you have any doubt, you can ask me. See, if you want to learn more about data science, this Finland lab, our company, basically, we have some training that is of 25 to 30 hours. That is a 2 weeks training, 3 hours per day. And you can join that training. Okay. So first of all, I'll tell you about that training. First of all, let me solve your doubts. Data science is only data preparing up. Yeah, that is the part of model and all. This is a part of ML. Yes, yes. See, that is a part of data visualization, Rajarani. That we can do in the map part, in the graph part. Yes. On this channel, there is no video of Python tutorial. On this channel, it's not there. How to find most predictive features? See, actually, we use lots of things in data science. We analyze the using the graph. We analyze using the graph. We analyze the data using the graph, and then we find out that which is the most predictive feature. We compare some of the columns. We compare some of the input by visualizing that in the graph, and then we can know which is the most predictive features. Okay, so we have lots of thing in the pandas. In the pandas, we have lots of thing that you can apply, pandas, NumPy. So in that data science workshop, let me show you about that. Wait. I'll share the link. You can join like in the next week, I think from 17th, next to next week, we are going to start that training. So you can participate in that training. And that training is certified by It is in association with the National Social Summit IIT Roorkee. IIT Kharagpur. Sorry. So you will get a certificate in the association with the NSS IIT Roorkee, National Social Summit IIT Roorkee, and it is conducted by Finland Lab. IIT Kharagpur, not Roorkee. Okay, Roorkee. So here you can see. That's a course content that we will be covering in that. it is totally from the scratch. It is totally from the scratch. Like if you don't know about Python, we will be joining, we will be covering the Python also in that. So Python, then Python programming, then we have a data science manipulation. In that, we will be covering about NumPy, different packages, how to install the NumPy, then array function and method, different mathematical functions, different matrix operation, random numbers, generating number between a range, this thing. Then we have a pandas, in which I will cover about series. These are the different topics that will be covered. Okay. Then we have a data frame. In the data frame, we have the topics like this. And from here, like all the days, you can see data frame is a very big topic. See, these all topics till day 7, we will be covering NumPy and pandas. So pandas is very big topic. Then we have a data visualization, how to plot data into different graphs. Then we have machine learning part, in which I will be covering two algorithms, linear regression and the logistic regression, in which I will be covering implicit prediction using linear regression. And this one will be the sales prediction of a company or Titanic passenger death prediction. Whatever the data set I have used here, I will be using this data set to predict the death. Okay, so this is overall the course content of this workshop. And it's a 2 weeks per day, three hours class will be there, Monday to Friday. 10 days class will be there in the evening, afternoon. So if you want to join, you can go to this link and you can join. The fees is 2200 rupees, 2200 per student. And if you are joining in a group, you'll get a group discount also. So it's starting from 17th of August and the timing will be from 2 to 5. Okay. And you will get the certificate. You will be assigned a project. You will get the internship later. Sorry, project later. With all things you will be getting. That's the benefits. All the session will be recorded. It will be on the GoToMeeting. It will not be on the YouTube. It will be on the GoToMeeting or Zoom. And every session will be recorded and you will get the recording of all the sessions. Okay, every day you'll get the recording. All the materials will be recording. All the materials, all the PPTs will be shared with you in that class. Okay, and it's totally for beginner. You don't have to, there is no prerequisite for this. It's totally for beginners. Okay, so I'll just share this link. You can go to this link and you can participate. We will share this in the group also. You can go and participate in the data science. And this training, I will deliver this training. And I hope you all enjoy this training. Okay. So if you click on book now, see, there are basically two fees here. The first one is 20. See, if you are doing it for 2 weeks, there is only 2 weeks. It's 2500. Sorry, I think there was some mistake. It's 2500. The fees is 2500. Okay. So you can go to this link and you can register. The registration is going on. You can register and book your seats, because there will be a limited registration in this and there will be less students in that, so that each student will be focused more. Okay. See, there was a mistake in the website. Right now it is showing 2500. Okay. So I'll just share this link on the chat. You can participate if you want to participate. Okay. And it will be surely benefit for you. It will be surely useful for you. You will enjoy this training. That's the link. And soon I will be giving the attendance link. So you have to fill the attendance link and fill the correct details. That correct details you will be, it will be printed on the certificate. And you will get the certificate link on your email ID, whatever the email ID you will fill here. Okay. The training timing will be from 2 to 5 p.m. 2 to 5 p.m. every day. And there will be separate doubt class. Last half an hour, there will be question answer round. There will be doubt class. Okay. How MLN
NMRL, what NMRL?
If you are, I think in the group there is a 300 discount. Let me confirm that. Yes, Monday to Friday, 3 hours. Yes. 200 discount on two tickets. If you are taking a, in a group of two students, you will get 200 discount. Okay. So you can participate if you are. So I'm saying the link again. You can go to this link and you can participate. Okay. So please do the registration if you are interested, because the, it's very near. It's only 1 week. And the training, the link will be soon closed for the registration, because we have already got some registration and we have limited seats. Okay. And we have the other training also. Like if you go here, I'll share this link also. If you are not interested in this data science, we have another training also that you can participate. Okay. Let me show you. See, there is a, this is for generally for students and faculty, 4 week internship program. In this 4 week internship program, 2 weeks training will be done on AIML and data science, and 2 weeks training will be done on IoT, Internet of Things. Complete hands-on training with them. Our all training is completely hands-on. 90% part will be hands-on. Only 10% part will be theory. Then we have a AIML training. Then we have a blockchain. Then we have a data science. Then we have a IoT. Then we have a 2 days training on COVID data analysis. That's a corona data analysis. And then we have a digital marketing. And then we have a 2 days training on Python with web scraping. Okay. Okay, Surlin, you have attended the IoT training. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that. Yes. Real-time experimental data, all things will be covered in that training. Okay. So I'll just share this link also. You can go through this link also and you can find it. Okay. C language training is right now not possible. I told you. Okay. We'll tell you if it's possible. Now I'm just going to share the attendance link. Please don't be in hurry. You will get half an hour. After half an hour, the attendance link will expire. It will be closed. So at 6 o'clock, I will close this attendance. Okay. So please fill the details correctly. Otherwise, your data will be printed wrong on certificate. Okay. So this is the attendance link. I will just post it here only. I will not post in the group. So it will be here only. And more, all the trainings will be focused on projects and the practical. All the training will be for practical. Okay. So in all the trainings, if you go to any training, like see if I go to the IoT, you will get the details about all the projects that we will be covering. Like if I go to the 4 week training, let me show you the projects and all. See, these are the projects that we will be covering in this: data manipulation, employee salary prediction, then iris flower classification using KNN. These are the machine learning projects. Amazon website scraping the data from the Amazon website or Flipkart website. Then we have a sentiment analysis, like review is positive, negative, or neutral. That is called sentiment analysis. Then we have image processing, face detection, detecting the face of a person, detecting the eye, detecting the smile. Then we have a artificial intelligence in which we have a neural network. Handwritten digit recognition using neural network, image identification and classification project, that is a cat and dog project, will identify the cat and dog image. That is the overall of the machine learning. If you come to the IoT, These are the projects of IoT. Input output for Arduino, Node MCU, LDR. We will controlling the brightness of the LED, controlling the home appliances from anywhere in the world. Okay, creating a local server and controlling the appliances. These are the projects that we will be covering in the IoT. Yes, see, we will not provide the hardware. This hardware, you have to purchase it from the market or online. We will provide the link for this and you can purchase it from the market. Okay. Okay. This was all about the training. You can participate. I'll suggest you can participate. That will be fruitful for you. Okay. So I'm just pasting the feedback and the attendance link. That's the attendance link. You can get it from here. Okay. So thank you so much all. I hope you all enjoyed the session. Okay. And yes, there will be discount. I only told you if you sign up in group, you will get a discount. Okay. Let me see if there will be some promo code. I will share it. It's possible. But if you sign up in discount in a group, you will get the discount for that. Okay. So sign up in group, you will get the discount. So I hope you all enjoyed the session. You can subscribe to this channel, Finland Lab, and you will get our trainings, other trainings related to in future. Okay. So maybe we will meet again. So thank you so much all. And please participate in that training. That will be more fruitful for you. Okay. Thank you so much all. Have a great evening and take care. I'll post the link again. If you miss the link, I'll post the link again. No, I cannot post in the Telegram. Lavanya, please take the link from here. That's the feedback form. I just posted. Just check. It's a feedback form. Yes, this session will be live. It will be active on this channel. You can come to this channel and you can have this video. It will be there. It will be here only. Okay. Okay. So bye all of you and take care. Bye.